sa pag-iisipa, itutuw po yan. Itutuw po ang inyong mga motorsiklo. So, pakiusap po sa may mga dalang motorsiklo, sa nagpag po, sa nasa o leisure park, kung pwede po o maaari po ay pakilagay na po pakipark sa tamang parking area o hindi po, yan po ay itutuw.
Right now, as you can see, they have lights on their engines as well as on their kites. And I believe they're going to be putting on a little bit of a show to keep us entertained while we wait for the weather conditions to stabilize for our balloons. Hopefully, they'll be treating us to some exciting acrobatic moves in just a little bit. You know that they have set the record here, actually, at the Philippine International Hot Air Balloon Fiesta. A few years ago, they actually launched themselves off of a hot air balloon from 3,000 feet. That has never been done before, and it was first done at the Philippine International Hot Air Balloon Fiesta. So what we've got here are truly experienced pilots who are ready to put on a show for everyone.
Okay, mga kaibigan, para magdagdag ng saya sa ating umaga, ito po.
Parang special, ano? sa Carmona, hindi daw pwede dito yung mga special ships. So only the circle ones.
Circle ones?
Round ones. So right now, right now, papunta kami ngayon sa mga boots. So let's see kung ano meron sa mga boots dito. And let's go! Nandito si Dora the Explorer.
Gala ng gala to. Pati dito makikita natin.
Pa-picture ka, baby. Please. Please. Bagay.
Kakainin ako niyan.
So, ito pala yung open field ng Carmona.
Gilid lang.
Oo. Lahat ng boots dito sa Flying Carnival 2020. So, merong mga nagka-kite flying. And meron ding yung ball na compared to four. So, we are looking for Takoyaki Sensei kasi yung isa sa favorite ni Vincent. And we're going to eat unlimited takoyaki here at the Flying Carnival 2020.
I'm Leonie.
Okay, so let's go. And here it is. Takoyaki Sensei.
Si Coco Marty.
Oh, wait lang. Ano yan? Kada ng pangalan?
Si Cardo.
Ay, si Cardo.
Si Coco Marty.
So this is Takoyaki Sensei. So this is the unlimited takoyaki. So kain na ba tayo, Vincent?
Gusto mo na ba?
Okay lang.
Oh, sige.
So kain na tayo. Habang ano pa?
Yung only. Oh, ganun pa rin, same price.
Oh, I'll go with the only din. Ano yung isa? Special regular. Oh, okay. Regular lang ako. Okay na ako sa regular.
Ah, ito. Sila rin mismo yung sa Tagaytay.
Yes, yeah, sila. Okay, let's go. So yung only nila is what time?
1 to 3.
1 to 3 and?
And ano ulit? 1 to 3.
6 to 8. Okay. Okay.
Spicy.
Spicy.
Really spicy.
So instead, we're gonna order their cheese bomb special.
Ah, dito yung mga meal talaga.
So as you can see in my background, daming nagpa-fly na kite. Diyan silang lahat. Gusto mo mag-fly na kite? Gusto mo mag-fly na kite?
Isa pa binibli yan?
Red
ba?
Hindi. Binibli ito. Oh! Ayan yung boot. Tada. Tada. Let's go na! Abunin natin takoyaki natin.
Putol-putol din.
Yung show din nila.
Wala naman dating.
Ayan, walang dating for him. Yeah, full review mamaya pag-uwi.
Mahal pa yun ha, sa 500.
Ay, actually, the entrance is 500 pesos and yun yan, sabi ni Vincent.
Mahal so, yan, may...
Tapos magkano yung parking?
100. Kahit sa motor, 100.
Ayun, so umahal din ng parking. So hi everyone, so nandito na kami ngayon sa bahay ni Vincent and time now is around 11:20 a.m. And good thing, malapit lang dito ang bahay ni Vincent kung saan naganap ang Flying Carnival Hot Air Balloon Festival. So as you can see, I have my codigo here and Vincent is sleeping on the background. So we decided to go home kasi sobrang init and wala naman talaga kaming gagawin na sa event grounds. We already watched the balloons, we already watched the twins paragliding around the area and we enjoy the food booths. But we might go back to watch the sunset to evening hot air balloon inflation and also the night glow show. So it is an event wherein the hot air balloons are covered with LED lights, siguro. I'm not sure kung ano, pero yung mga balloons is umiilaw daw siya. So, it's an exciting scenery to watch. Buti na lang, you can easily re-enter the event grounds with this stamp. Yeah, so with this stamp, wait lang, hindi atak na yan. So, with this stamp, pag nag-exit kayo ng event grounds, tatatakan kayo ng stamp, and if you want to re-enter, pakita mo lang, and you're good to go. So, we actually tested this one kasi after the balloons have flown one by one, we decided to get my tripod kasi naiwan namin sa sasakyan. So, yun, in-stamp kami and we re-entered and everything is okay. So, without further ado, here are my observations and my tips on how you can maximize your Flying Carnival experience with an economy ticket just like us. Number one, be early. Yes, I know, it's very cliche, dapat dumating ng maaga, blah, blah, blah. Pero kasi, limited lang ang parking. Ay, well, hindi naman talaga limited, pero sobrang lawak ng parking area. Pag isa ka sa mga unang nakarating, doon ka mismo sa unahan ng entrance makakapark. Yes, that's right. So, even if you're a motor or a car, parking fee is 100 pesos. And agahan nyo kasi nga ang ganda ng parking sa unahan. Plus, once you get inside, you will have the best seats. Diba ang weird economy ticket ka, pero bakit ka may seat? So, with the venue in Carmona, compared to Clark, Pampanga, ang mga economy ticket takers ay merong free seats doon sa bleacher side. So, nakita nyo naman sa video ko earlier, we were seated right at the center of the event grounds and it was beautiful. I love that spot. And yeah, we're very lucky na maaga kami nakapunta. Number two, wear sunblock, wear your sunglasses, wear your caps, and pamaypay. Red your pamaypay kasi sobrang init talaga. During the sunrise, malamig pa yung hangin. But once nalumabas na yung araw, sobrang init as in. So please wear comfortable clothes, wear breathable clothes. Better prepare yourselves for an intense heat. Number three, surprisingly, you can enter light snacks. That's right. So, bawal talaga magpasok ng kahit anong food. But based on my experience, hindi sila ganun kahigpit when it comes to light snacks. So, I was able to bring inside my mini chocolates. Malilit lang naman na chocolate yun. I know it's not a big deal kasi nilit lang naman chocolates and all. But still, having light snacks inside the area, makakatikid kayo in a few pesos, di ba? Well, I'm not sure if you can bring your own drinking water and your own tumbler, but maybe you can try. Or maybe I can try it later on, but we'll see. Number four, you can actually bring your own monopods and tripods. That's right, because before there are some events na hindi pwede magdala ng monopods or tripods. So, luckily, pwede magdala ng monopods and tripods. Vincent and I were able to have our own selfies and a couple photos because I have brought my tripod. Number five, bring enough cash, please. Especially mga barya. Not really the barya coins, but the barya 20s, 50s. Kasi, usually sa booths, ubusan na sila ng mga barya nila. Lagi sila, wala po yung smaller bill and all. Pero, just in case na you didn't bring enough cash, surprisingly, merong isang ATM machine doon. I think, I remember the ATM is RCBC. So, yeah. Buti na lang may ATM machine. Number 6, mahina ang data signal. Well, ng Globe. I'm not sure kung mahina ang data signal ng Sun. I was trying to upload some of my IG stories about the event and upload some photos of it. Kaso nga lang, ayaw talaga. Because maybe there's a signal jammer or whatever. So, please be prepared. Number 7, compared to the venue in Clark, there are actual restrooms. in the venue, diba? Big deal yun. Kasi, doon sa Clark, puro portalets lang. And, syempre, hassle sa portalet kasi makikita mo yung wiwi nila and all. So, malinis naman yung restrooms, pero as usual, sa girls CR, mahabang line. So, girls, be prepared with long lines. Number 8. So, despite the intense heat at around 9 a.m, mainit na agad, the event is actually very organized. So, maraming security guards roaming around the area, maraming guides, pag nawawala ka, marami rin mga placards, marami rin signs para malaman mo kung anong meron sa side na yun, anong, saan makakabili ng tickets, and saan ang restrooms and all. Number 9, ulitin ko ulit, please hydrate yourselves kasi sobrang init. Good thing na lang, maraming food booths sa event at kaya masaya si Vincent. Kasi you know, Vincent, he loves food so much. So actually, I'm not sure why, pero ang daming takoyaki booths, ang daming soft drink booths, or anything drink na booths. So there are milk tea, soft drinks, water, lemonade, you name it, ang dami doon. There's also Shakey's, there's Kenny Rogers, and sino pa ba nandoon? And there's also Jayco. Hindi ka magugutom, and surprisingly, their prices are cheap. Yes, that's right. So, hindi sila nagdagdag. Kasi usually, di ba usually sa events, nagdadagdag sila ng mga presyo sa mga food items nila. But, not with Flying Carnival. So, side note, ang kanilang water bottle is only 20 pesos. So, not bad, di ba? And last but not least, number 10. So, number 10, just smile. Yes, I know, again, sobrang cliche. Pero, just smile because from ang daming camera sa loob ng event. So, from vloggers to official media partners like ABS-CBN, TV5, and all. So, better smile, enjoy the venue, enjoy the event, and let's all be thankful to the Philippine International Hot Air Balloon Fiesta because they brought back the Hot Air Balloon Festival here in the Philippines. Also, I'm very thankful kasi this time sa South naman because I'm a South person. I love traveling to the South compared going to North. So thank you for bringing the beautiful hot air balloons here in the South. So that's our Flying Carnival 2020 experience day 1. So hindi na kami pupunta sa day 2 and day 3, but based doon sa sinabi nila, there will be fireworks and there will be drone shows, drone light shows during the weekends. Make sure you guys enjoy and comment down below if you will attend this weekend's Flying Carnival 2020. And if nakapunta na kayo, comment down below kung ano ang best experience nyo. Ano yung best experience nyo? Na, ano yung best? Ano yung pinakanatuwa kayo sa event? Oh my God, I don't know what to say. Okay. Whew. Oh my God, this vlogging thing. Anyway, that's it. Before I forgot, huge shout out to DJ Vanessa. Oh my God, I was so amazed. Sobrang, pero parang, I'm not sure, sobrang in awe ako sa hosting niya. And very knowledgeable talaga siya sa kanyang hot air balloon facts. And I love it so much. So, it was nice meeting you, DJ Vanessa. And yeah, hope to see you around.